I don't think it's gonna be that bad. I really don't. It's sad that we're not getting the game that we wanted. But I mean, it did sound in the article like they were working on something really great. But you know, they can still do something with this. They really can't. It's sad that they're starting over, that we're not gonna get this amazing game that they were planning. You know, let's give him a chance.
Whatever are you talking about, darling?
In our last fight, I saw you take a blow. If I'd been there quicker...
Ooh, I'm getting everything for a greener garden.
Aren't you precious?
I appear to have offended.
No, dear. You couldn't possibly offend me.
Ooh. They're flirting. Okay, we're gonna go over here and rest a little bit. Recover some of that lost health. Okay. So let's see here. I think we've got more we can do here in the hinterlands. Yeah, we can do these rifts over here. So let's fast travel over here. Well, you know, the industry's going to this whole live service model thing, and from a business standpoint, it makes a lot of sense, but it's just an example, as far as I'm concerned, of corporate greed ruining art. I mean, I know that some people, probably not people who are watching streams on Twitch or Let's Plays on YouTube, but so many people would be skeptical of this, of calling video games art. But I mean, movies are an art, television is art, you know. It's if it's not art, what is it? Here, man, before you attack me, I'm gonna get you. I'm not doing him any damage. It's the hill. Stupid hill. Okay, there. Come on, come on. We can do this. Oh, and now there's... Outlaws, what? But anyway, you know, there's a way to do live service or games as service models well. Basically, bottom line, what it comes down to is make sure gamers are able to have a good time, even if they just want to do the base game. I mean, it's as simple as that. Where making those extra purchases are optional. Honestly, I think Elder Scrolls Online is... I really do. I I'll occasionally, if there's something I really, really want, I will occasionally, you know, drop some money on usually story DLC. That's the only thing that I think is worth it typically. You know, some cosmetic items. You know, I liked making my characters have nice homes to go to, you know, getting fine furniture and stuff like that. And I did invest in some, I did invest some in, I did invest some in some cosmetic things, like women's hairstyles, mostly because I wanted to be able to change, get some variety in my character's adornments and hairstyles without having to completely redesign my character. I don't want to completely redesign my character because you know how much it costs to change your character's appearance? The character appearance change token is basically about $10. And I'm sorry, I don't want to pay $10 every time I just want to change my character's hairstyle. But if I pay $10 once, I can get access to all of the hairstyles. Come on, Despair Demon! Come on! But my point is, I guess if they want to, they want to reinvent their business model to be more lucrative. But come on. Think about, I have a lot of skepticism about the corporate mentality, but you know, you didn't come here to hear me rant about that, and I've already gone on too long about it.